Welcome to Beer Untapped with Perry Miller, the podcast. I'm joined by Seth.
Hey, welcome, guys. Thanks for finding us on the internet.
Now, these shows originally aired on Brookings Radio, but now they're all here for your enjoyment. I hope you like it.
There you go. Sit back, enjoy the show, relax. Let us know if you want to see anything on future shows. As we said, this comes out live in the Brookings area, but enjoy this archive episode.
Beer Untapped with Perry Miller. Welcome to Beer Untapped with Perry Miller. This week on Beer Untapped, the weird stuff they put in beer. From the seemingly sensible to downright strange, they're putting all kinds of ingredients in beer these days. You only need water, grain, hops, and yeast to make some really great beer, but they're going way beyond that. Some additives make a lot of sense. Chocolate or coffee in stouts, for example.
Then they start getting into some of the more experimental realms, whimsical, if you will. You'll put chilies in beer. You can definitely throw in anything from bacon to some breweries have even put donuts in it. So there's real no limitation on it. Maybe your own imagination and your own palate.
That's Seth Cook, head brewer at Wooden Legs Brewing in Brookings. Oysters, Rocky Mountain oysters, even goat brains
Ew.
Have all been used to flavor beer. Now, those are extreme, but adding other stuff to beer is nothing new. It's been going on for thousands of years.
Spruce tips is a very traditional way to bitter out a beer. Crow Peak has a spruce tip ale that is fantastic. Honey, of course, was one of the fermentables that they had access to at the time. There are beers, and these are coming back into fashion, that are even partly wine as well. Dogfish Head out in Delaware actually has a number of beers that they ferment with grape must as well. So the lines are really blurred when it comes to food and beer.
Tyler Luckhurst, general manager at Pints and Quarts in Brookings, says competition is probably driving a lot of this.
With over 3,000 breweries that have opened up in the United States, and of course many more around the world, it's the palates are ever changing with a lot of its consumers, and so they have to really get creative. So it's always unique to see what new styles or what different takes on styles that have been around for years. What actually comes out of those.
More on specialty beers and strange styles when Beer Untapped with Perry Miller continues.
Behold this liquid of gold. What friendships are made of? Why stories are told?
Welcome back to Beer Untapped with Perry Miller. We continue our look at specialty beers from the weird and wacky to downright sublime. There's some really interesting things going in beer these days. Now, among the 35 taps of beautiful beers at Pints and Quarts, you'll often find a specialty beer or two. Tyler fills this in on this week's Mike Tap Handle Beer of the Week, a new Goza from Sam Adams.
Sam Adams, as part of their limited release series, came out with Sam Adams Verloren, which is an ale brewed with coriander and salt, typical to that Goza style. It's got a creamy and spicy body with a nice dry finish. It's a nice summer beer.
Brennan Sully Sullivan at Pints and Quarts says Goza is his favorite kind of specialty beer.
A true German Goza is one of the most interesting ones, I think, brewed with coriander and salt. And you think, God, salt in a, brewed in a beer, you get a good one, and they're amazing. It's weird.
There's a tear in my beer, 'cause I'm crying for you, dear.
There's some brand new beers available at Brookings Liquor Store that fit the specialty category. They've got some from a rapidly growing Quebec brewery called Brasserie Dieu du Ciel.
The first one is Root the Eyepiece. It's a rye beer brewed with peppercorns. It has some real heat to it. I mean, it's not like Ghostface Killer, but I mean, if you like spicy food, it's a good one to try. The next one is Blanche du Paradis. It's a wheat beer brewed with spices. It has a fairly strong coriander flavor to it. It's nice and refreshing. It's a good summer beer. And the last one is the Rosy de Hibiscus. It's an ale brewed with spices and hibiscus flowers. It's got a nice tart, dry flavor to it.
Thanks, Drew Eklund, our Brookings Liquor Store beer guide. And here's your chance to try an extreme specialty beer. Wooden Legs has brewed a beer that plays off this region's fondness for red beers, beers with tomato juice added. It's an innocent-looking lager with hot, hot peppers added. It's severely pepper-jacked up.
So we ended up putting some local-sourced chilies, some very, very hot chilies, with the intent that the beer itself would be crystal clear. It looked pretty mild or look ambiguous, and then when you were to taste it, you'd actually get the full chili flavor and even as importantly the chili heat. So Taste of Brookings is coming up on Saturday, and we're going to be putting our beer out with the Wooden Legs Brewing Company's red beer.
Then on August 22nd, they're going to do a full-on red beer tasting bar. By the way, I've tasted the beer undiluted. Crazy hot. Now, my pick of the week, Schell's Frambois du Nord, a Berliner Weiss infused with raspberries. It's a beautiful, hazy, light red with an amazing aroma of fresh raspberries just picked from the garden. At first taste, all raspberry, tart, slightly astringent, just a slight and not unpleasant funk as well as the beer warms. A little finishing bitter note that's quite nice. It's a great beer, and they have a couple of bottles at last check of Frambois du Nord at the Brookings Liquor Store. And that's it for Beer Untapped with Perry Miller. Remember to check us out and like us on Facebook and all the episodes online at BrookingsRadio.com. Next week, the Brookings Wing and Brew Fest. Drink local, drink responsibly.
Thank you for listening to this archived edition of Beer Untapped with Perry Miller. Feel free to listen to other episodes, and if there's anything you'd like us to talk about on a future show, please let us know. Thanks again.